What's up, guys? Unicycle Willie here with an Icon helmet. It's called Doodle. And Cardo Black. It's a bold. So, installation, there's pros and cons. The pros, these are easy to remove. The headliner, I removed from the back, stuffed it in the visor. And the MIPS, I just kind of, there's two back here, there's two snaps. And there's holes in the MIPS where the snap goes through the hole and it kind of holds the MIPS because the MIPS needs to be able to rotate and stuff. Anywho, so getting this on was a pain in the ass trying to slip that on. That's the position it worked for me. I was going to do the 3M tape, but if you go too forward, the curve on this helmet is too great. So it won't get 100% of the sticky attachment. And then back here, it'd feel a bit better, but I didn't like it being way far back. And so you just gotta force this and you will have a gap. You can see here, there's a gap right there, and a little bit on the front. But other than that, here's what the non-gap side looks like. So a little bit of a difference. So anywho's, so you wanna take these off. There's Velcro here. And then there's a couple snaps. And then you want to pull this through the hole. Here's one of the snaps right here. As you can see, the other snap is higher up. There's the JBL speaker right there. Here's an issue. This helmet is a small, and it fit pretty snug on me without being too tight. But the next size up was loose. I could rotate my head and the whole helmet would shake. So either one, my head isn't the right shape for this helmet, but I really like this helmet. So I just went with the small because it fits really well. And I like the design, the look, and the feel when I'm riding. It's not too noisy for me. And it feels pretty stable. Anywho, so these are the 45s. They fit perfect. Except for one issue. It's only like that deep. So these would stick up. They wouldn't be flush. They would stick up probably 3 mil, 5 mil, pretty high. And when I put this helmet on for my ears, it'd have pressure and my ears would not flip back up. They'd stay folded. And I couldn't rotate and like, you know, you could wiggle your head in the helmet. Couldn't get that. So what I had to do was cut away the styrofoam. Now the styrofoam is probably like this thick and it goes all the way to the shell of the helmet, so you'll be able to see the plastic. So the first one, I took all of it out and I'd use some foam and then glue it in there, and it fits good. On the other side, I was got some knowledge about the, how deep the foam is. So what I did was I got an X-Acto knife, made lines going all the way across about 5 mils deep, and then I'd go the other way, make like hashtags. And then I'd get a flathead screwdriver, small flathead, and I'd just pop up those little pieces, and they're like little chunks, break off really well. And then I kind of smooshed it, flattened it, and then the speaker laid perfectly inwards flush. And that's it. And then routing the wires, you have to go, I went under the MIPS, I routed this here, went all the way around here, under the MIPS, put the MIPS spec down, and then you can see here, just route it through this crack, and you can see the other wires there. And then you have it connected in. And then this is the mic, which, let's have it go all around here. And then I'm not using the boom, I'm just using that little guy right there. And that placement, I closed my air vent, and the placement there, then people say I'm a little soft, so I got to figure it out, or else I might have to go to the boom, and I could bring that boom closer to my mouth. Another issue that came around is the headphones have a 3.5 headphone jack, and they go, that little clip goes into, there's holes, I think they're breather holes for the foam. So under the MIPS, it's, the hole's like right here. And you just go straight in. I just tucked the 3.5 mil in there. And it's kind of tight on this cable here, so I had to scoot this back just a hair to release some tension on this cable. I got to figure out a way I might 3D print something or figure something out to keep this cable from flapping or figure something out. And this one gets held down by the Velcro. Then you can go around the snap if you want and all that. But other than that, it's pretty good. The speakers get pretty loud. Downside for doing one side with foam and the other side just cutting a little bit of styrofoam is the one with a little bit of styrofoam is not as bassy. And the one that I took all the styrofoam out and I used, where's this foam at here? So this is the foam I used. And I had to cut it at an angle because the way this helmet is shaped, it's curved. It's kind of flat. It goes pretty deep. So I had to make it like this. So when it went in, it was like it made it flat for the speaker. Anywho, I did this and I compressed it, glued the speaker in, and it has way more bass. It's not going to be like you got 12s in your helmet, but it's a lot bassier than just using the straight to styrofoam. Anyways, hopefully this video isn't too long. And then just button her all up. Make sure you get your MIPS in those holes on those two snaps. You can put your headliner back in. I didn't take it out, as I said previously. I just pushed it all the way in the helmet to get it out of the way. Kind of a tight spot, but once you get these off, it's easy peasy. It's just the cable management. It's kind of a pain in the ass. But if you have any questions, just relay them, and I'll try to get to them later.